10 minutes, yeah, 12 minutes.
Good evening. My name is Frankie Kitten, known as a wise entrepreneur. And my guest speaker is my dear friend, who we collaborate quite a lot. And we have loads of great topics to talk about. And this topic I'm going to talk about this evening is the importance of a mastermind group. My guest speaker, Roger. Hello, Roger. How are you, sir? How do you feel about the topic today, my good friend?
Okay, so mastermind group, to me, it's being able to connect with other people, okay? And to be able to share ideas and concepts and whatever, to have a laugh, to talk about something serious, to create connection with other people. And I think it's even involved. And we obviously we do it online. A lot of those events, mastermind groups, used to happen in workshops based, like a full day workshop. It used to, or half a day, in some different places across Manchester, because this is where we come from, Manchester in the UK. Because I know there is a Manchester in the US, but Manchester in the UK. Okay.
And all the way to the United States over here, Roger. Yeah. Fly over there, eh?
And then, for me, it's really important. I mean, mastermind seems to be maybe a posh word. I don't know, mastermind, but I think it's to actually. Is to help people to brainstorm and communicate with each other and in the group and outside the group when possible. And I think that's important. And personally, even more so, we are all in confinement in one way or another. Earlier today, I was speaking to my French friend, Jean-Marie. My dad is also called Jean-Marie. But now they cannot go because there will be such a surge in France of COVID-19. It just exploded in the last day or two, unfortunately. And anyway, the confinement is quite strict there. They cannot go more than 1 kilometer out of the house. So in other words, if I was in France now, I couldn't go a kilometer more than my house. Oh, well, unless the supermarket is over that and there is no other shop. But apart from that, it's a kilometer. You're allowed to go around an hour a day to go to stretch your leg, go in nature, do some physical exercise and stuff like that. But my brother is allowed to visit my dad. That's a good job because he lives alone. Yeah, now. So I think that it's so more than ever, we need to communicate more than ever. And mastermind, pardon?
Because you've been here for quite a long time in the UK.
Yes, I have been.
Broken Call Mastermind?
Pardon, say that again.
Broken Call Mastermind.
Oh, Mastermind is, why do we call it Mastermind?
The quiz show is Mastermind.
I'll have to apologize, Frankie. I can't hear you fully. Can you say it again?
The show is called Mastermind.
Oh, yes, there is a show.
About them four people who answer different questions on their topics.
Oh, yeah, it's a quiz show. I don't think I've watched that before. I've seen a few, I've been watching a few quiz shows on the UK television, but I have not watched Mastermind, yeah, but I knew the name, yeah, about Mastermind.
The Mastermind, Rosé, they choose a topic. And it's important that they know as much as they can about their detailed topic to score points and get the most points at the end of the show.
So yeah, that's right. Yeah, I don't watch it. It's not quite true. I watch a few episodes of it, but not many.
So I'm saying, as a mastermind, it's important to know your topic. Do you feel that as doing mastermind groups, it's important that we know the topics that we're going to talk about? Is it make it easy to do the mastermind group? Because I see mastermind groups as an easier way not to make mistakes as an entrepreneur or in a business venture or as a thought leader. It masterminds us to make less mistakes as we possibly can. Because Tony Robbins is a great entrepreneur and the great thought leader and public speaker. He said that we all make mistakes, but to make mistakes and decisions quick, we can rectify them as soon as we can.
Right, make decision quick. That's what
quick, was. To be rectified our mistakes. Would you agree with that, Roger?
Yeah, that's a good point, actually. Well, because sometimes we, excuse me, and then sometimes you have to, how can I put it? Because often we don't make a decision quick because we are afraid to make a mistake. And then we procrastinate, don't we? And we all do that in one way or another at some point, I think. Yeah, and then so being able to make a decision quick is actually an asset, I think, for you, because it means then, okay, I made a decision. That doesn't mean you've got to be reckless. It doesn't mean that, because some people may associate it to being reckless. Yeah, I mean, make a decision quick. Sometimes you need to take a step back and make that decision. Yeah, okay. So I think that's also important, but that doesn't mean you got to wait a week or two or three or four before you make a decision. Do you understand what I mean? So because otherwise it just postpones it, and then what will happen? Then it just doesn't happen if you don't make that decision. Yeah.
Thank you, Roger. So that's the importance, isn't it, Roger, of having mastermind groups or mastermind sessions or meetings or webinars. Everybody can bring something to that group of value that we master with our minds to limit our mistakes, but to learn as much as we can from other people. Mm-hmm. It gives us a foundation, Roger. It gives us a real grounding of what the skills are and techniques we need to be successful in society and in life.
Yeah, because when you belong to a mastermind group or a networking group, we could call it as well, country. And then, so you're a networking group or a mastermind group is that you're bound. Sometimes you could feel that some people may know more than you do, or they may have some more experience than you have, that and that kind of thing. And I think it's important. And sometimes I do feel like that, and again, okay. But we have to think that everybody is at different stages in their life, okay? So, and I think, for example, today, Sam doesn't have a business, but he introduced himself very simply. And very generally, he said, I am a full-time dad. I don't know if he mentioned his job as a chef, but, you know, so it was very simple, his introduction, and genuine, yeah? And he felt good, because I don't know how he feels, obviously, because I can't read him, I am not him, but he felt good that he was able to do that, whereas some people already have some company, export this, export that, export the other. But it's good that it doesn't matter what you do, we all feel at the same level. I think that's also very important, because it's so easy to feel down compared to other people.
Or so feel inferior, in other words, Roger. Feel inferior to other people. Feel not as good as other people.
Yeah. I think that's some type of feeling we can have. Absolutely right. Yeah, and I have a tendency sometimes to feel like that. And but by going on a regular basis to those groups, then this kind of feeling fades away.
I think the skill of an entrepreneur and a thought leader and a business person, Roger, is to mastermind how you can be at the same level as that person, whether you're mentoring, coaching, teaching, or educating.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's always important that you both like that at the same level. Mm-hmm. Because you're learning more, and they respect you more, and you respect them more, and you tend to learn more and grow better together, Roger. It's really
Absolutely. Yeah, and then we got to accept that we are all different. People are different journeys in their life. Yes. So I think it's going to. I don't know how to put it, but I think that's the way I see it. So, for example, I mentioned a lot that I have a YouTube channel. When I introduce myself, but I am not monetized yet, and that kind of thing. I'm going to reshape it. The kind of video I do are going to be similar anyway, but I'm going to reshape the main trend of it, the main meaning of it. And then, but I could feel a bit, down because, these people, they've got that video, they've got 75,000 followers. That one has got 100,000 followers, like my brother down the road, he's got 100,000 followers plus. I keep forgetting the name of his channel. I took a picture of it because he put it outside his shop. Yeah. And so I had to have a look. And however, I could feel, he's good, he's young, he's quite fit. I'm sure most girls will like him. He looks handsome, that kind of thing. He's a nice guy, if you know what I mean. So in your mind, and he's tall. So in appearance, he's got everything going for him. The girls are going to like him. He's got a successful YouTube channel because he's got over 100,000 subscribers and he's got a big trophy from YouTube in his shop as well, in his barber shop. And I am glad I went because I had a feeling they had to ask him to close, even though it was not decided. So I went to the barber couple of weeks ago, and I'm glad I went. Otherwise, I would be stuck for another month before I could go to him. And but anyway, cut a long story short. Yeah, I could feel, he's young. The people are going to like him. I am 61, or people are not going to follow me because I am 61. This and that and the other. And so it's so easy to go into a negative thing. So by attending, and I'm sure there are people over 40. That are interested in YouTube. It's not the same audience, but it doesn't matter. But what I'm trying to say here, we must not feel below other people. We are on our own journey. And then some people might say, it's easy to say. But when you belong to a mastermind group, every people in there are focusing on positive things. They are focusing on on their goals, on their aspirations and stuff like that. So you can be inspired by other people in that group. And it means that, how can I put it? Because I heard the saying that we become the result of the five most people we frequent in our life, or we are with in our lives. So if we are with people who are negative all the time and pull you down, yes, friend or no friend, and if they pull you down all the time, then that's what you are going to be. You are going to be feeling down. So for your own sake, try.
Well, Roger, as I've got older, is that me as a person, my journey, my success is important to me, nobody else. If we follow other people, and there's a good saying which my friend Quincy Adams says, he's another YouTuber, a great friend. She said, comparison is a thief of joy. Comparison is a thief of joy.
Can you say that again, please? Sorry.
Comparison is a thief of joy.
Right.
Yeah? So don't compare ourselves to other people. It's our journey. It doesn't matter how long it takes. The idea is to mastermind and learn and grow as much as we can by other people. Everybody we meet, ladies and gentlemen, it's about growing and learning from everyone we meet. If we learn from everyone we meet, we'll become a better person. And success is more closer to us than we actually think. So, Roger, thanks again for coming into my YouTube. Any little tips, anything you want to say while we wrap up this actual YouTube video?
Well, just basically people out there who are viewing this, do not forget to subscribe obviously to Frankie's channel and have a peek at mine as well, Roger's Well and Adventures, if you don't mind. Okay, but otherwise, yeah, it's with the pandemic, I think it's a great, especially we are in lockdown in one way or another. It's so important to connect with people as much as you could possibly can. And just to keep your mind going, because it's so easy to get depressed, isn't it? Especially these days, yeah. Okay, but...
Roger, be the master of your mind rather than letting your mind master you. That is what we mean by master mind. So, Roger, thank you so much. You know my YouTube channel. Subscribe, leave a comment below, hit that notification bell. And we'd love to know what you feel a mastermind is or what your thought of a mastermind is. What has it done to you? I'd love to hear your comments. My warmest wishes to you all, entrepreneurs, infopreneurs, ladies and gentlemen, great business people. My warmest wishes, take care to you all, and look forward to seeing you on our next video channel. Okay. Bye. Thank you, Roger.
Bye-bye.